There's too much going on.
Thank you. say, I don't penalize on-time people.
Amen.
I apologize that we are 5 minutes late. Come on, let's praise the Lord. Come on, let's give the Lord a high five of praise. Hallelujah, these words need to be praised. Come on, bow our heads. Father, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for this time, Lord. We thank you for this season, which is representing the birth of your son. Hallelujah. Yeah, we hear the naysayers. We don't know the exact date he was born. We don't know it was on the 25th of December, but we do know he was born. We do know that you gave him for us. And God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever shall believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life, Lord. And we come to celebrate the birth of Jesus, Lord. We ask and we thank you for each and every person that is here tonight. We thank you for each and every family that is going to be represented in everything we say and everything that we do tonight. It's to lift up your name and celebrate the birth of your son. So bless us, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Thank God. Thank God. Amen. Before you have your seats, go on and shake somebody's hand you didn't come with. Tell somebody Merry Christmas. Tell somebody God is good. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Yes, he is.
But we want to celebrate and have this party tonight. Amen. theme this year was called, "What Does Christmas Mean to You?" And we have a lot of memories. I don't care how old you are or how young you are. You have Christmas memories. And you know all about the birth of Christ. So tonight, everybody's just going to talk to us and then explain to us in their own way, the representative from each family or the group, what Christmas really means to you. And before we start, I'd like to call up Sister Frankie for a welcome.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody, because God is truly, truly good. And He is the reason for the season. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm here to welcome you to Start Right Church of God in Christ tonight. And I thank each and every one of you for coming out. And God truly will bless you just for coming into His house. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Thank you, Sister Frankie. I'd like to first start off by having a presentation from the Cresswells. Cresswell Ways, I'm sorry. The Ray family. Deacon Chris, Brother Cresswell and his wife. Come on up. Use this mic.
Of words, but it was an annual thing.
I'm gonna know if you're one of the words. If I can keep this microphone in.
I feel better.
so much better since I laid my burden down. I'm going home to live with Jesus since I laid my burden down. I'm going home to live with Jesus since I laid my burden down. Glory, glory, hallelujah, since I laid my burden down.
We enjoyed that. Our next presentation will be from the Brown family. Brown family. Amen.
Believe, believe, believe the wind. Thank you.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. God is good, isn't he? All right, so what does Christmas mean? So we got parts in this, so we're going to be switching back and forth. Amen.
All right. What Christmas means to me.
Amen. So we share our presentation because we wanted you to have the visual. As we go through this presentation, and as we were thinking about Christmas, there's Christmas with Jesus or Christmas without Jesus. We understand he's the reason for the season. But I know when I wasn't saved and I was doing things my way, I wasn't doing things God's way and celebrating Christmas. And so, Christmas minus Jesus equals, and this is what it looks like, okay, Pastor, thank you. And when I think about Christmas minus Jesus, there's commercialism, there's ungratefulness, greed, unforgiveness, selfishness, debt, guilt. And when I say guilt, meaning people want, give me. And sometimes people don't have it, but they feel guilty, so they do it. Unrealistic expectations about what people provide, and hopelessness. And so when I think about Christmas and it's in the way the world celebrates it, it celebrates it, and these are the kind of things you see when they celebrate Christmas and there's no Jesus attached to it. It's loveless. And the scripture that came to mind was 1 John 2:15-17. Do not love this world nor the things it offers you. For when you love the world, you do not have the love of the Father in you. For the world offers only a craving for physical pleasure, a craving for everything we see, and a pride in our achievements and possessions. These are not from the Father, but from the world. And this world is fading away, long and with everything that people crave. But anyone who does what pleases God will live forever. And so when I think of Christmas without Jesus, it's a spirit and a presence that can deplete the hearts and minds of people when it's celebrated the world's way. And so when I think of the meaning of Christmas and I think about it minus Jesus, that's what comes to mind for us. But then when you think about Christmas with Jesus, there's joy and peace and hope. There's compassion and humility, gratitude and forgiveness. There's a concern for others, giving from the heart, solutions for every human problem, salvation, healing, deliverance, and power. There's love. And so when I think of Christmas with Jesus in it, it brings things that enriches our lives and strengthens us. It's not about us, it's about other people. And so it's a completely different view when you celebrate Christmas, understanding that Jesus is the reason for the season. It's a spirit and a presence that enriches the hearts and minds of men and women, boys and girls. And so it's a different, I see Christmas differently since I've been saved.
Life without Jesus Christ is like a journey without a destination, a pencil which has no point. What Christmas means to me is a life full of options, opportunity, and overflow.
Amen. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing with us what Christmas means. And that's what this night is all about. We are saying that this is his birthday party. But what does Christmas really mean to you? I remember one year, my father, he had this habit. He would never open up any of his gifts. He would put them on the side of him. And he'd shake it and try to figure out what his gift was. But one year, I kind of like said, I got to find something so special for my daddy. And so what I did was I found a Bible, and we had grandpa's name engraved on it. And I said to him, there's no other gift that I can give you but the Word of God. And I believe he used to use that Bible all the time. And I thank God for putting that in my heart for him, because I know You know, sometimes we go shopping and we do a whole lot of different things, and it may be in the spirit, it may be not in the spirit, but I just thank God for that special memory that I have as for what Christmas means to me. My family used to always have to, my brother, sister, and I used to always have to pick five things, and they, my parents would have them there, and God just blessed us to have wonderful Christmases, and we knew the meaning of Christmas, and the giving and the sharing, and just the spirit of love throughout Christmas. So right now I'd like to call Pastor Reddick. About to mess up your name again. I didn't say it this time, Saint. Something's going on there.
Praise the Lord, saints. God is good all the time. This is a Christmas gift that showed what Christmas should not mean to you. It means so much to us. The love of God, the birth of His Son to save the world. The spirit of giving, the humbleness of receiving. The time of the year that gives you the most joy. Christ brought so much joy to the world with all of His precious promises. Embrace it. Remember the happy times in your life. Have a Merry Christmas. Honey, at this time we're having some financial problems right now. And I know you want to buy everyone in the church a gift and your family. But can we just spend some time together and just enjoy Christmas together?
Thank you.
Because of what I heard, saw that one day, and I thought it was so cute. And I thought about, wow, how people are just so, I don't think the word is just greedy. For lack of another word. You know, you want, he'll give you all you need. And that's not the time. Christmas time is not the time to want. But I thank God for that little presentation, and that is not what we want. Amen?
Amen.
We don't want to go in debt. We just want to enjoy our family. You know, it's nothing like tasting a sweet potato pie for your mom. You know, it's nothing like sitting there and watching someone smile as they open up a gift that you gave a lot of thought to. But it's not what you want. It's the gift of giving, the spirit of giving. And so that's what Christmas means to me. So when I was asked, why did I choose that topic? Because really, this is the time of the year that we are, I don't care how mad you are of your coworkers or how you don't get along, everybody becomes so jolly around this time of the year. Please don't let them get good cheer, you know? Amen? So, without further ado, I'd like to see if the minds are ready. If not, we can call Brother James first, and then maybe right after him. Brother James? He comes. Amen. Amen. Let's give him a hand as he comes.
Go check. able to do exceedingly, abundantly above all you can ask for, think, or call into the power that worketh in us.
Oh,
morning, heart deepens and not come. Amen. We certainly enjoy them.
Beep! Pam, Richard, Joseph, Old Town.
We have no roots. Literally, no roots.
So Mary and Joseph walked away sadly, but then he said, the only place in here in Bethlehem that you can stay stable. And then he just pointed the way and they followed. When the shepherds were taking care of the sheep,
then they saw angels.
The angels said, a new baby is being born, who is king of the Jews. The angel was singing.
Bethlehem, whatever, didn't know nowhere to go, and she was in labor.
but no place to go. She was a tired woman and a man huddled in a stable. They finally found a place to go, which was in a stable. And it was a silent anticipating the arrival of a child. We know as mothers that have children and fathers what it is to wait for a child to be born. Sometimes it can take 2 or 3 hours, sometimes it can take 24 hours. We don't know how long Mary was in labor, but she was there for a while. So it wasn't nobody there to help Mary but her husband and the leading of the Holy Spirit, God. So it was sad anticipation, the arrival of a child. Beside them, listen, humble animals. Animals were with her. But God had the animals trained where they would not disturb them. They were somehow or another, they knew what was going on, so they stayed on their own side. The animals did not. It was beside them humble animals, which watched, they watched quietly as Mary began to give birth. Undisturbed by these two strangers, they did not bother Mary or Joseph when the baby was getting ready to be born. They were in a stable, and the baby was getting ready to be born. So the angels, the animal was on by themselves. So then we go down further, and we see a distant away were shepherds. The shepherds were there also watching over their flock, which was the sheep. And unaware of an impending angelic visitor, the angelic visitor was going to be Christ. No one knew what was going on in the manger but the ones that was in there. Then three kings rest in their camp. They was out waiting for the arrival of the baby to see where the baby was being born. They looked to the east and saw a star, which the star led them to Bethlehem, where the baby was being born in a manger. Soon began a journey to honor the Christ child. That's when the three kings headed out to find the baby, which was laying in a manger, because they had no room in the inn for it. Then the celebration of Jesus Christ is an occasion for a rebirth of my awareness of the Christ Spirit within me and within the Christ Spirit within all of y'all sitting out there is the Christ Spirit in us. This comes from the birth of Jesus Christ, the Spirit that's in us now. Before I sleep this evening, I rest in the presence. Before I go to bed and go to sleep at night, as you all do, we are resting in the presence of the Spirit of God, which is in us. That is a blessing, a blessing. Tomorrow is the dawning of a new day for our promises, which we do live by promises which was given to us from the Holy Spirit through God. We have a lot of promises that is before us, and we can depend on our promises that God gave us. And that was the story that was going on up there that I was telling you about, the birth of Jesus, how he was born, where he was born. And I'm going to give you the scripture, Luke 2:7. And you can read it, and it will tell you. But as I read this, I want you to answer me one thing. And she gave birth to her firstborn son. Who gave birth?
Mary.
All right. Now, they say the baby was wrapped. What was the baby wrapped in? Well, all right. And laid him where?
In the manger.
Because there was where? What?
No room in the inn.
All right, give yourself a clap. And that was it. You can read Luke 2:7. And that will tell you about Christ being born, okay? Right. Now I'm going to take you in the past. That's me and anybody past, I say for me past 70, okay? But anybody else that's got children that is up and their children is grown, then you will understand this as I read. It's just a form, and it's taking us back to Christmas past. When I say Christmas past, I mean taking us back, because our children, I am a great-grandmother, but I'm taking you back where we had our children are still having children, making us grandparents and great-grandparents. But this is how it was when we was coming up, and I'm talking to the children, too. Now, it's just a little form. Each Christmas, I remember. I think each Christmas, all of us remember back in the days. The ones of long ago, way back there, we remember this, church. children, y'all listen to me. It ain't like it is today, but y'all have them. I see our mound place adorned with stockings in a row. Each Christmas finds me dreaming of days that used to be, and it does. As each Christmas comes now, at my age and some of y'all age, we think about what we went through for Christmas. It wasn't easy, but it wasn't bad. But our Christmas, to me, was much happier than these Christmases are. Because we were glad to get what we got. We was happy. We played together. We loved. We shared everything we got together. That's the way we was brought up. We didn't want a whole lot of things. We just asked for a couple of things. And we got it. We got it. So each Christmas finds us dreaming of days that used to be, when we had presents here and there for all the family. And we did. We had presents for the family. My mother and them would wait for us to just draw those pictures in school and put "I love you," "Merry Christmas," although we couldn't spell that well, but the teachers have done. So we would always give our parents Christmas gifts, if it wasn't nothing but a little card that we made in school. And they were happy to get that. Nowadays, it's hard to get anything from children now. Because they want everything, but you have to remember, you have to be good to families also. You have to be good. Each Christmas, I remember the fragrance in the air of roasted turkey and mince pies and cookies everywhere. Our cookies was made because we helped Mom make them to put them out just for who? Santa Claus! Yes! And we had cookies made. And each Christmas finds me longing for Christmas. Wow, Christmas now passed. And it does. As I say my age, I think about when Christmas come now. I think about those days. They were happy days. These are happy days now. Kids get more now than ever. And you would think we were poor, but we're not poor, I see. Because their money is being spent for everybody now. Parents getting stuff, kids getting stuff, and that's a blessing. But I want you to know your blessings don't come from leaving this red outfit. If I look at Mr. Claus, it's not coming from me or my husband, Mr. Claus. We just want to give credit where credit is due and give honor and honor to you. And we want you to realize everything you get, yes, Santa brings it, but who prepares it? And we just want to just say thank you to the parents today, too. Thank you. So as now as I am back in childhood, as long as memories last, and I do go back to childhood. Even at 72, I go back to childhood and think about my past. God has been good to all of us as he is to y'all today. And I want the children to remember, this is a blessed day, but it's not about presents, and it's not about toys, it's not about this. It's all about Jesus Christ. That's what the season is. The reason for the season is Jesus Christ. And I want you to remember this here. And I want to say Merry Christmas to all of you out there. And especially to those that remember the past. Amen. I want to say Merry Christmas.
Good evening, everyone. I want to say I'm so happy to see so many of you all here this evening on this cold winter night. And we are all so blessed. We are all highly favored. And I just want to say to the young people that did the dance, that was a wonderful thing of improvement they did. That was a great part for the little girls, the little boys, the people, that was a blessing. I'm going to read a poem and say what Christmas means to me. To some, Christmas means there's presents beneath the tree. To others, the children's laughter as happy as can be. So Christmas means all that I must admit and means more to me. It means celebrate and share the good news with family. The good news is Christmas is the birthday of our Lord. The Son of God, salvation delivered, is the living word. Christmas is a time to thank God for sending us his Son. It was through his life and because of the cross that our salvation can be won. Christmas is the time of the year to express good, love, and will. This love was given to each of us through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Praise him on this fabulous day of celebration. Let us all take time to worship him through the faith. So So it is my wish to all your loved ones too, a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Gives us Mr. Amy and Sister Lola Walton. Let's give them another hand. And we're now going to have Maria Perry come up.
Well,
want to thank everyone. I'm talking, and you're talking, and I'm talking. You talking and I'm talking? So we just want to thank everybody for coming. Can y'all see my lips?
Yeah.
We want to thank Missionary Hicks for being prepared to give the word, but so many of you already gave the word that we felt we just was going to end with the kids here. And they already said, happy birthday, Jesus. And you guys already know the reason for the season is what?
Jesus!
All right, and that's the most important thing we can leave you guys with.
Right?
Oh, you want the mic, you want the mic.
How you doing?
Scared of him, okay, I don't want to scare you. All right, you come on closer, come on. Come on, all right, there you go, all right. So we're going to get ready to dismiss, and we have some, and what are y'all looking at? Y'all really think you're talking to me? But we have some refreshments for everyone in the back, and we thank you guys for being so liberal and coming out in your shells and doing things that we've never seen anyone do before. I'm looking forward to next year where Pastor Rennick is praise dancing. So we're looking forward to a good time. We thank you guys. We thank you parents for allowing them to come and practice and get all this nice paint on their faces that's going to take a long time to get off. But we thank God. We thank God for each and every one of you. So we're going to get ready to... We're going to play a song and then we're going to get ready to dismiss. Amen, amen.
So I wish you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And God-